In 2011, the government, through the Ministry of Energy, initiated the acquisition of more than 465.52 hectares of land in Karuma, Nora, Awo and Akurudia villages in Kiriandongo district to make way for the construction of 600 megawatt Karuma hydropower project. However, 12 years later, a section of the project affected persons petitioned Parliament over this delayed compensation.
Thoroughly investigate compensation issues around Karuma hydropower plant, that the government should adhere to the guidelines for compensation assessment under land acquisition, and that the government should urgently construct houses for displaced households.
Members of Parliament on the Committee of Natural Resources learned that the ministry has only compensated 89% of the PAPs, leaving others to suffer for over 10 years. According to the ministry, the total number of PAPs were 1,174, of which 1,049 were compensated, 125 claims are still outstanding, while 6 claims are before courts of law.
In such a way that it does not affect the school. Because the schools have gardens, you have the school structure, then your school can have a farm or something, and this is being affected. So in the case of Karuma Primary School, the school was not affected.
When some people are still demanding their compensations, and secondly, I don't know how these cases would be, the ones that are not yet compensated.
When should you have concluded the issue of compensation of the PAPs?
Lawmakers expressed concerns that Article 26 of the Constitution, which provides for prior, adequate and fair compensation for the government to acquire land, was violated.
Of fair compensation, timely and adequate. Which article is that?
Where the PAP is not cooperative, we cannot force them to cooperate. And if they are before court, then it becomes a matter of the courts of law to decide how much to be compensated.
It also came out that 119 project-affected persons who were supposed to be compensated in kind by resettling them to new houses have never received their promised houses.
Now to know, where should we take these people? Meaning now, before, the plan was not there. So it is just coming at this time.
So the real challenge was acquisition of the right land to resettle. And remember, first, the character of this land must be that it must be within a community that these people can easily be resettled in. You're not going to pick them from Karuma.
The committee also queried circumstances under which compensation for PAPs has almost doubled due to delays in payment of disturbance allowances and interest accrued from deleted compensation.
Compensation assessed under this section, there shall be a disturbance allowance of 15%, or if less than 6 months' notice to give vacant position is given, 30% of any sum assessed under subsection 1.
Be a disturbance allowance of 15%, or if less than 6 months' notice to give vacant possession is given, 30% of any sum assessed under subsection 1.
Legislators are scheduled to have an interface with the project affected persons before proceeding to the ground. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.